हाय फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। दोज हु आर न्यू, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। इन टुडेज क्लास लेट अस सी कम्युनिटी। फर्स्ट वी सी व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कम्युनिटी। ए ग्रुप ऑफ थ्री आर मोर पीपल लिविंग इन ए पर्टिकुलर ज्योग्राफिकल एरिया विद कॉमन रूल्स, रेगुलेशंस, वैल्यूज एंड कॉमन आइडेंटिटी, इट इज कॉल्ड एज ए कम्युनिटी। कम्युनिटी इज कॉल्ड एज ए सोशल यूनिट। All communities produce and supply the goods needed for the human beings within the territory. This means the community is dependent on various professions of its members for its production, and it has a unique food production and composition pattern, and it has always fill various basic needs like water, shelter and other aspects based on the social life, professional future, cultural life, beliefs, economic system and population. The communities are divided into four types. They are nomadic, tribal, rural and urban. In today's class we see only two of them. Now let us start. Our first type of community is a nomadic community. Now let us see what is the meaning of nomadic. Nomadic means, according to encyclopedia, says that nomadism is a way of life. Nomadic community is a group of people who wander from one place to another place according to the season for the purpose of hunting and food gathering, animal husbandry and trade. This wandering is different from a migration process. Nomadism is called as a Sanchari in Hindi, Pokani in Tamil, Tenuduri in Tulu, Tirugubhutu in Telugu, Tenti in Malayalam, Nomads in Latin and Nomad in English. Along with this nomadism, it is also called as a Vachalaya, Gypsy and many other names. Now let us see what are the characteristics of a nomadic community. First one is a nomadism for life. Second one is a temporary shelter. Third one is a zero or no investment job. Fourth one is a universal beings. Fifth one is a different mother tongue. Now let us see one by one. Our first characteristics of a nomadic community is nomadism for life. Nomadic people wander from the hunting, taming and exhibiting of animals, animal husbandry practice of native medicine, exhibiting folk art, etc. Those are all the works of nomadic people for their livelihood. For example, exhibiting tames, bears and monkey and snake, folk art like puppet show, dispensing native medicines, selling smaller goods and doing repair work of the various objects are the features of those nomad peoples, means nomadic peoples. Now let us see our second characteristics of nomadic people is temporary shelter. Since they have no permanent residence and lack of education and fixed sources of income, they live in temporary shelter erected outside the village under some trees in the public places. Now let us move on towards our third characteristics of nomadic people, that is zero or no investment job. Those communities do not have any economic security. Many of them earn money through picking, bucket repairing, fishing, hunting, selling small fancy products. Those are all the jobs of nomadic peoples. Our fourth characteristics is a universal being. They have immense knowledge of nature and they have a strong belief in nature's invisible force and worshipping them. Our fifth characteristics is a different mother tongue. Their mother tongue is totally different from us. Nomadic community includes many races and every race has its own mother tongue. Those are all about the nomadic peoples. Now let us move on towards our another community, that is a tribal community. The biological and sociological scientist uses the term tribe in different meaning. Kittel in his Kannada dictionary, he defined the term tribe as a family or clan. It is originated from the Latin word tribus, and Greek Roman writers uses this term tribe for the first time to indicate the tribal of Latinium districts. Now let us move on. A group of clan with kinship is called as a tribe. In Kannada it is called as a Budakattu. The tribal people are also called as a Adivasis. గిరిజనాస వినాయజతీస్ అండ్ మూల నివాసీస్ ది రాయల్ ఆంథ్రోపాలజికల్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ లండన్ డిఫైన్ ది ట్రైబ్ యాజ్ ఎ గ్రూప్ విచ్ లివ్ ఇన్ ఎ పర్టికులర్ జియోగ్రాఫికల్ ఏరియా అండ్ దే హ్యావ్ దేర్ ఓన్ సోషల్ పొలిటికల్ అండ్ కల్చరల్ అడ్మినిస్ట్రేషన్. A physical anthropologist, after the study and the physical characteristics of a human body, they have divided the tribe into three major types. They are the Caucasian, Mongolian and Negro. Those tribal group peoples are white, yellow, black in color respectively. Now let us see one by one. Our first tribal group is Caucasian. The people of this tribe are white in skin color. They are tall. They have long, straight, sharp nose and bent head, straight cheek, small lips, long hairs on body and light colored skin as their characteristics. Caucasian peoples are found in Europe, North South America and Palestine in Asia, Iran, Balochistan and Northern India. The subtribe of Caucasian peoples are Nordic, Alpine, Mediterranean and Hindus. Now let us move on towards our second type of tribal group is Mongolian. The Mongolian tribe peoples are yellow in color. The physical characteristics are round head, curved eyes, flat and round face, straight and long hairs, etc. Those peoples are found in eastern side of Asia, Malay Peninsula, Iceland and in America also. The subtribes of Mongolian tribes are Mongolian, Malaysian and American Indians. Now let us move on towards our third type of tribal group is Negro. The physical characteristics of Negro peoples are round head, flat nose and small round bone eyes, short curly hairs, big fat lips, etc. Those peoples are found in Africa, Australia, India. In those areas we can see the people of Australia and India belong to this tribe. The sub-tribe of Negro is Malaysian Negro and short black people. Three tribal peoples are again subdivided into many groups. Now let us move on. The three important geographical zones where the tribes live in our India, those are: first one is North and Northeastern zone, second one is Central zone, third one is Southern zone. Now let us see what are the characteristics of tribal peoples. First one is simple and self-content. Second one is worship of nature. Third one is royal to the community and importance to the unity. Fourth one is equality and independence to the woman. Fifth one is endogenous marriage. Sixth one is unique and different mother tongue. Seventh one is living in a nature environment. Eighth one is economic system based on the hunting and gathering of minor forest produce and sporadic agriculture. Those are all the fruitful information about nomadic peoples and tribal peoples. This is the end of this video. Thank you for watching this.